Hello and welcome to Tech at Work. I am Reema Tendulkar. Cloud, AI, and data analytics. If you didn't know it by now, it's time to know it. These are the three most common technology words that come up in meetings, emails, and conversations as a starting point for discussion. So today, it's not a deep dive, but a back to basics as we de-jargonize these commonly used technology words. Cloud. A broad term to describe a system of storing data on a different server and accessing it via the internet instead of your own computer hard drive. The data, when it's stored on your own computer hard drive or server, is called on-premise or on-prem data. Now, cloud is in three forms. One is a public cloud, where you're using the cloud services that are open to the public to store applications or files and access it via the internet. Private cloud. Cloud computing that is dedicated solely to your organization. And third is hybrid cloud, which is an environment which is a combination of public and private cloud. Private cloud is more secure, customizable, but more expensive. Public cloud, since it's shared by many organizations, will be cheaper, but you will have less control over it. Artificial intelligence. A machine or software technology that mimics human intelligence. Rather than the computer following preset commands, artificial intelligence or AI can learn, solve problems, and self-correct. Natural language processing is a subset of AI. NLP or natural language processing allows machines to understand the human language as it's spoken, like Alexa or Siri. Natural language process performs classic functions like spell checkers, machine translation to emerging innovations like chatbots, voice assistants. Again, I'm going back to the example, Alexa and Siri. Machine learning, or ML, is a subset of artificial intelligence. Machine learning is the use of algorithms to help machines learn new information without having it to be programmed. Machine learning guides things like product recommendations a user gets based on his past purchases. Netflix, for instance, taps the streaming history and habits of its millions of users to predict what individual viewers are likely to enjoy. Or autonomous vehicles, autonomous cars can get into many different situations on the road. The car has to learn and adapt to the ever-changing behavior of other vehicles around it and make decisions in real time, so the software is constantly learning. Data analytics. Intuitively, we know that data analytic means, by definition, is examining raw data with the purpose of drawing conclusions about that information. Because data on its own isn't useful, we need to analyze it to draw insights. There are three types of data analytics. The first, descriptive analytics, that tells you what has happened in the past. Very commonly used because it's analyzing historical data, like in the production function. Predictive analytics predicts what is likely to happen in the future. Prescriptive analytics recommends actions you can take to affect those outcomes. The vast majority of statistics that we use today falls in the descriptive category, which is basically using past data, analyzing the past data, something in production finance. Moving on to predictive analytics, wherein you're using the data to predict the future, an example of it would be a credit scores. Now, these are used by financial services to determine the probability of customers making future credit payments on time. Prescriptive data analytics goes beyond descriptive and predictive analytics by recommending one of the possible courses of action. But this is complex because it has to be applied against input from many different data sets, including historical and transactional data, real-time data feeds, big data, and hence most companies are not using it in the daily course of action.